Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adaeze, and in this video I'm going to be telling you about some very weird pregnancy symptoms that I am sure you've never heard about. At least one or two of the symptoms that I'm going to talk about today, I'm sure you've never heard about it, because even myself, if not that it happened to me, I would have been like, yeah, right, like you're kidding, right? Okay, so yeah, let's just jump right into this video. So first of all, let us address the elephant in this room, okay? Yes, I cut my hair. I remember in one of my videos, I told you guys that I was going to cut my hair because of my husband, this and that. Just know that all those reasons were out the roof once I got to the peak of my pregnancy symptoms, experience, okay? Once I got to the peak, you guys, I woke up one morning, I called Amarachi, I said, go and bring scissors, I want to cut my hair. She was still laughing, she thought I was joking. I said, Amarachi, go and bring scissors for me. She brought the scissors, I said, okay, cut. She kept on laughing, I took the scissors from her, snip, snip. And that was how I cut my hair, guys. Yes, I couldn't cope with the pregnancy symptoms, the stress of staying at home with the kids, because they're not going to school. I literally did not have any break, my mom was not around. I felt like I was losing time. Also myself, one thing has to give, okay? It's my hair for my mental stability. Okay? I had to just let my hair go so that, you know, I won't let my mind go, okay? Yes, because my head was full, okay? No pun intended, but my head was literally full. So I had to cut my hair. Anyway, yeah, so pregnancy symptoms that I experienced. I'm going to tell you guys most of my pregnancy symptoms, but I'm starting from the really weird ones because I've not heard about them before they happened to me. But after they happened to me, I went and did my research and I saw some people say they've experienced it, okay? Yeah, so number one, I hated, and I still do, hate the feeling of fan on my skin. Let me explain. When you put on fan close to me, my skin starts to crawl, I want to vomit, I start gagging. The kind of cold that enters my body, not even cold, because I can stay in very cold AC, yeah, but it's not really cold, it's just that feeling of fan on my skin is, it was so disgusting before. Even till now, I still can't cope much with it, but it was worse before, okay? Right now, I have a fan on in this room, but it's a fan that has a very low speed, so I don't really feel breeze on my body, okay? Anyway, I don't know how to explain it, but I saw somebody online that said she felt the same thing. I'm just like, oh, thank God. So let me come and tell you guys, in case there's somebody here that is feeling the same thing or has felt the same thing, please just leave a comment in the comment section. Let me know that there's nothing wrong with me, okay? But yeah, one of the pregnancy symptoms that was so weird to me was I hated the feeling of fan on my body. Even on days when we don't have light and it's just the inverter and I have to use just fan, I literally cover myself with a blanket and put on fan. Like, I'm trying to stay cool, but I have to cover myself with a blanket so that I don't feel the fan directly on my skin. Anyway, weird as it is, that's also happened to me, okay? So the number two weird symptom that I experienced is that I feel like I started to get body odor, okay? Now let me explain. I've asked my husband, do I have body odor? He said no, but I could literally smell my body. Okay, I could smell my body. I could smell everybody's body. In fact, I hated smells. I hate, like, even till now, I'm still trying to cope with some smells in this house because they're inevitable. So, for instance, what we use to clean our floors, air freshener and stuff like that, I hate the smells, but they're inevitable, especially when you have kids in the house. Our washing detergent, I hated the smell of comfort. What they call the name? Fabric softener, I hated the smell. Gosh, like, I had to rewash most of my clothes after Amarachi helped me to wash my clothes and she used the comfort, okay? I had to go and rewash all my clothes again because I couldn't stand the smell. Even when we used it to wash my bed sheets, I had to go and rewash the bed sheets again, okay? So I hated smells, which is, I think that one is pretty normal with a lot of pregnant women. But the one that was off for me was I hated the smell of my own body, okay? So I saw myself having my bath 3 times a day, 4 times a day. I just could not stand the smell of my body. Even when I was using deodorant, okay? So even when I use deodorant, I just been having my bath, use deodorant, and maybe I go to bed and I just put my hand like this and I can smell my armpit. I'll go to the bathroom and go and wipe it off, okay? It was just that bad. I just couldn't stand smelling myself. So yeah, so I heard that some women actually get body odor when they get pregnant, while some people are just smelling their body differently. I don't know, but all I know is that I just had weird body smell, which I hadn't experienced in my first two pregnancies. The next one, which is kind of related to, you know, the fan feeling, I hate, even till now, I hate and I hated bathing with cold water. Mind you, before now, I never used to bath with cold water. I always use warm water. No matter how cold the weather is, I am going to use warm water. I might not use very hot water if the weather is hot. I'll use, you know, lukewarm water, which is more on the warm side. Okay, I hope you guys get that. I don't like using cold water to have my bath. I don't just like it. Now, after I got pregnant, that feeling became worse. Okay, you know how you jump into the shower and then you put on the shower or the shower head and then cold water comes out first before hot water. That feeling of cold water pouring on my body was so disgusting, guys. Like, the moment the thing touches my body, I'll start gagging, I'll start holding my throat. Like, my body will just be, I'll be so disgusted, okay? So yeah, what I usually do is, when I'm trying to test the temperature of the water, I have to face, I even stopped using the overhead shower, I started using the shower head. So I had to face the shower head somewhere else and make sure the water is warm before I nudge it on my body, okay? It's not like before that I could tolerate that little coldness before the warm water starts coming out. Right now, I cannot tolerate it at all. Another pregnancy symptom that was weird for me is that I hated anything sugar. I know that many women have aversions to different food and different, you know, types of food or whatever while they are pregnant. My own is that I hated a complete group of foods, which is carbs. I hated carbs in any form, in any shape. I hated the taste of sugar. I hated if anything tastes, even if it's slightly sweet, like I'll be so disgusted. I couldn't stand the thought of licking ice cream. Like, when I see people licking ice cream, it just felt so disgusting to me. I bought gummy bears for my prenatals. I didn't want to start taking pregnant care, the capsules or the drugs. I just wanted to take gummy bears, thinking that because it's gummies and I can just chew it and swallow it, I'll be more consistent. Because fun fact, in my previous pregnancies, I stopped taking I stopped taking my prenatals at 11 weeks. Forever, I stopped at 9 weeks, and I stopped taking it throughout the pregnancy. Okay, so this one I said, let me share. This is when I'm not getting any younger and I'm not really eating so well, so let me take my prenatals. Okay, so I went and bought gummy bear pregnant care. You guys, it is the most disgusting taste in the entire universe. Right now, I don't have that aversion so much, so I can take my gummy bears now, but even till today, I can't take them without chewing garden egg immediately after. The bitter garden egg, I had to chew the bitter garden egg immediately after taking my gummy bears, and I didn't want to throw them away, I didn't want to keep them aside, I didn't want to go and buy the normal pregnant care, I just had to take them because they're not cheap. So yeah, I started liking things like beans. In fact, beans became my best food. I'll eat akara in the morning, afternoon I'll eat beans, or moi moi in the night I'll eat beans. That is, if I eat moi moi in the afternoon, in night I'll eat, you know, beans pottage or whatever. Okay, so yeah, that was just my life for the first 12 weeks. I hated carbs. Like, when I say I hated carbs, I mean, even when I'm eating salad, if any vegetable tastes kind of sweet, maybe like the carrots, if I could taste the sweetness of the carrots, it used to mess with my head. Yeah, that's one pregnancy symptom that I've never experienced before. In my previous pregnancies, I actually loved carbs a lot. Like, I was only eating carbs. I used to eat bread and coke. I'll drink one coke while eating the bread and drink one coke after I finish eating the bread. Yes, I did it when I was pregnant with Kaora. Okay, so for this pregnancy, I just could not stand carbs, and that is why I lost some weight at the beginning of my pregnancy. Like, right now, I am just getting back to the weight I was weighing before I got pregnant. I'm just getting back to it now, okay? So I'm not really gaining much. I'm not even gaining any weight, to be honest. It's just, I'm now getting my body back. And that reminds me, if you're one of those people who predicts gender based on symptoms, okay? Just, I hate to break it to you, but just know that it doesn't work that way, okay? I've seen people who had different pregnancies and had the same gender, and I've seen people who had pretty much similar pregnancies and had different genders, okay? So the symptoms you experience while you are pregnant does not determine the gender of your child, okay? I said what I said and I meant what I said. So another symptom that I have been experiencing, but this one is not new to me because I experienced it with all my pregnancies, is that I become extremely hairy. I am now very, very hairy. I've always been somewhat hairy. At least I'm not a bald person. I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, I've always had hair on my body. My hair has always been very full and all that. But in pregnancy, it becomes worse, okay? My armpit hair, I shave almost every 2 days. It will still come out again. I don't know what's going on. Even the hairs on my legs grew so long that I had to start shaving my legs again. For a while, I stopped because to me, it was just a waste of energy, okay? But right now, I have to now start shaving my legs again because I'm literally turning into Chewbacca. Do you know who Chewbacca is? I'm literally turning into Chewbacca. Yeah, so that I think that's part of why I don't even have a problem with cutting my hair, because my hair will grow back. The hair is even too full for me at this point. I'm even looking for how to reduce the hair again. But let me just respect myself and leave it like this, because at least at this stage I can braid it, or I can, you know, cornrow it, or I can wear my wigs. That's why I'm leaving it like this. So if not, I will go and use clipper and scrape it down to the roots, because I had to choose a struggle, okay? So yeah, I become very extremely hairy in pregnancies. You guys need to see my eyebrows before I shave them. You need to see my eyebrows. I look like, you know how Angry Birds eyebrows are? That's how my eyebrows look, you know, before I shave them and now use eye pencil and make them look, you know, cute and all that. Anyway, yeah, so I experience extreme hairiness while I am pregnant. Hairiness everywhere, yeah. So yeah, another pregnancy symptom that I have been experiencing, and I'm sure many pregnant women experience this because I experienced it in my other two pregnancies as well, is that once I have breakfast, it is game over, okay? Game over, time out. Like, I have to go and sleep for a few hours. Like, it's not possible for me to stay awake after I've had breakfast. Like, how is that possible? My body literally shuts down. And it shuts down in a way that it is almost as if I have been drugged. Yes, it's almost as if they have drugged me, they have chloroformed me, and I just cannot stand on my 2 feet. I have to go and lie down and sleep for one or two hours before I get myself back. And I'm just like, okay, good morning, everybody. Time to start the day by 2 p.m. Yeah, so that's why most times I try, if I want to film videos like today, I try not to have breakfast until after I have filmed my videos, okay? If I have to go to the market, or I have to go out, or I have to go and do something important, I just avoid breakfast until I am back. Because if I try it before I do what I want to do, just know that I'm not going to do it again, okay? Or even if I'm going to end up doing it, I'll end up doing it very late in the day, because your girl has to go and lie down and sleep off the food that she ate. I think it's just your body's way of, you know, shutting down so that you can digest the food better, okay? So yeah, so those are the main weird ones that I've been experiencing. The rest, nausea, yes, I experienced a lot of nausea. I experienced a lot of vomiting. I experienced a lot of, you know, sleeplessness, tiredness, body aches. Anything you can really think of that really comes with pregnancy, I experience most of them. But one thing I have never experienced in all my pregnancies is spitting. I don't understand that spitting stuff, okay? I've never been someone to spit. From what I have studied, I mean by my observation of people, I think I have noticed that people that spit a lot during their pregnancies are people who naturally spit even when they're not pregnant. I mean, I might be wrong, but I feel like a lot of them are people who naturally, like when they smell something or when they see something or when they inhale something, they have to spit to get that feeling off their body. I'm just guessing. So I feel like there are people that usually when they get pregnant, the spitting thing becomes worse, because I've never experienced spitting. I experienced being phlegmatic, okay? I had a lot of phlegm in my throat. I had a lot of mucus, catar, everything, but I did not actually spit. The only thing I would do sometimes is that I'll go and force myself to vomit all that accumulated mucus in my throat, because it became so bad that at some point I would be gagging just on my saliva. Like, I'll just be gagging. So I wasn't spitting, but from time to time I used to go and clear, you know, my throat, basically. Another pregnancy symptom which I experienced, which I think is kind of weird, or I don't know, if you've experienced it before, let me know, is that I become more introverted. I become more asocial, whatever. I just do not want to associate with people as much the moment I get pregnant. I don't know why. Everything starts to annoy me. Everybody starts to annoy me. But now it's not so bad because I have kids around me that I just have to take care of, whether I like it or not. They did not send me to go and carry belly like Nelo said. They did not send me. So I have to take care of my kids. So I try to cope. And now I'm on YouTube. I have to, you know, make videos. I have to reply comments. I have to talk to people. I have to, you know, reply DMs and all that, you know, so I'm forced to not be so in my shell. But ordinarily, I remember during Kaora's pregnancy, like, you won't see me anywhere. You won't see me online. You won't see me out. I will just be indoors, morning till night, sleeping, eating, watching Netflix and watching movies. And that was my life. And I felt happier that way, okay? So now that I am not able to be that way, I think that's what messed with me the most. It wasn't even about most of the symptoms. I think what messed with me the most is the fact that I couldn't retreat or go back to my shell the way I used to go to. I couldn't refresh myself. I don't know how to explain it. I feel like I was constantly just giving and giving. I'm giving to the baby, I'm giving to my kids, I'm giving to my husband, I'm giving to my friends, I'm giving to YouTube, I don't know how to explain it. If you're an introvert, I'm sure you understand it. I just could not cope with it. So even though I've not even discussed this with anybody, which is weird, so even though I try to, you know, keep up appearances, I try to laugh, I try to, you know, be friendly and all that and all that, just know that deep down inside me, I am crying because I want to just go and lie down and sleep, and nobody should talk to me for 3 days. Nobody should talk to me. But yeah, it's just what it is right now. It's something I'm constantly battling every day. I'm constantly just holding on to my sanity just so I don't just lose it or get depressed or, you know, start having issues, you know. I'm constantly battling that side of me. But anyway, I'm fine. I'm okay. So if you've been sending me DMs or emails or whatever and I'm not responded, just know that this is part of why. It is not that I'm trying to avoid anybody, I'm trying to, you know, do anything. It's just that if you notice, I don't even post much on social media. You don't see me posting pictures or whatever on social media. Sometimes I just come there and, you know, share something I find interesting or whatever. I don't even go on social media that much anymore. I don't even go on YouTube that much anymore, which is funny because I use YouTube as entertainment as well. But I don't even go on YouTube anymore that much. I don't even watch Netflix that much. I'm just pretty much in a state of, let me not say confusion, but I'm still just trying to center myself and just be zen and just be happy with myself. So yeah, apologies if I've missed your messages. I'm sure when I'm in the mood or when I get back to things, I'm going to respond, okay? So yeah, that's it. Any other weird pregnancy symptom? Nothing much. That's basically all the symptoms I'm behind. So I say that's basically, actually a lot. It's a lot of symptoms, but yeah, that's just the way it is with me right now. But I'm still thankful to God. Everything is fine. I'm fine. The baby is fine. My kids are fine. My husband is fine. Everything. We're all good. Okay, we're good. As much as this year has been a roller coaster of a year, I'm still good. Okay, and I'm looking forward to my birthday. Even though before, my birthday plans was bikini loading. I wanted to show off my abs on my birthday. At this time, I'm going to be showing off a different kind of abs, but whatever. But whatever. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below if you relate with anything I've said or if you've heard of anybody who can relate or whatever. And yeah, share this video, like this video, and subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.